Hey everyone, this is a quick demonstration video for a TEAC A-3440. This is a four track 15 and 7.5 IPS reel to reel tape deck. We're just going to record something. We'll play it back real quick. We'll see how it sounds. So this was definitely designed by TEAC with the musician in mind. It has overdubbing capabilities, so it has a playhead, a sync head. For you to be able to sync up to pre-recorded tracks, drums on one track or drums on two tracks, guitars and vocals on the other track, kind of a setup. It can also be used as a quadraphonic or as a home audiophile reel-to-reel tape deck. Everything on this deck works great. I replaced the main drive belt. Just a quick note, we are recording with Ampex 456. That's what this tape deck was calibrated to from the factory. It's one of the only Ampex 456 tapes I have. It's starting to show minimal signs of shedding, but it'll be good enough for this demonstration video. But this deck is in phenomenal condition. It was really, really well taken care of. The heads look mint, like brand new. Cosmetic, I would easily rate this on the vintage scale 9 out of 10. Just phenomenally taken care of. Everything on it works great, but let's record something. We'll play it back real quick. We'll see how it sounds, and then we'll go through some of the features and functions of this really well-made TEAC 4-track reel-to-reel tape deck. So we're recording to tracks 1 and 2. We are also listening to what's being recorded, the tape. If we hit this button right here, that's what's coming in from the CD player. So that's CD, that's tape. Let's flip back and forth between the two. Go ahead and stop the tape, and we'll stop the CD player. Now we'll rewind it back to the zero marker point, and that should put us right at the beginning of where the music started. Brakes work really good. Now if you hear some squeaking, that's actually the Ampex 456. Like I said earlier, this tape is starting to show signs of shedding, so it's getting a little sticky, but it's the only tape that I had to really show how well this deck can record, because it's the only +6 tape that I have right now. But it is starting to get a little sticky, and it's starting to squeak. So if you hear that, that's not the deck, that is the tape. Let's play it back, and we'll see how it sounds. Thank you. Yeah, that sounds phenomenal. That really does. I mean, the reproduction is just amazing. All right, so this is, we recorded and played back at 15 IPS. This is 7.5 IPS. Oh, sorry. So that's 7.5 IPS. This is the pitch control. Pitch control works great. I'm gonna go ahead and fast forward it now. Like I said earlier, this tape is starting to get a little sticky. So I'm not going to do too, and that's, you hear that noise? That's the tape. That's the tape kind of sticking to the tape guides. So with normal tape, with good new tape, you know, it would be whisper quiet. Brakes work really good. Let's fast forward. This is rewind. Yeah, really great deck in amazing condition. These are becoming really popular because, you know, you can overdub them, do drums, or you could send stem work to them, like stereo drums, stereo guitars, or record drums, kick, snare, overhead left and right. Possibilities are a lot with these. They're just great decks, and this one is in amazing condition. It sounds phenomenal. Records and plays back great. See, there's that squeaking. That's the tape. So, but anyways, fantastic reel-to-reel in perfect working condition. As always, I highly recommend getting new tape. The modern equivalent to Ampex 456 would be RTM SM911 or RMGI SM468. Heads are factory aligned. Everything works great. Just a beautiful reel-to-reel tape deck in really, really good condition. Oh, and one more thing. This has got a really good monitoring system. So you could record with this without a mixer because it's got a headphone monitor volume control, but you can also control what tracks you hear and what tracks you don't hear in your headphones. It's also got an input and output for each individual track. So you can create headphone mixes for overdubs. Just tons of possibilities with this deck. Really, really great deck for recording studios in the modern era. If you want to warm stuff up, you know, this is a fantastic deck to do that. But anyways, thanks for watching.